There we go. All right, let's try to adjust this a little bit. Right. Hopefully it's not too much on the gang swing. But anyway, what's up, fam? What's up, everybody? Like I said, I'm back. I know you guys know that if there's nothing else that I look forward to each and every Sunday, it is actually coming on here to do trending topics. Because like I said, I could just shoot this video and just upload to YouTube, but it's even more fun doing it live and us getting the opportunity to, you know, just sit here and bounce shit off each other's head, you know, chit chat and all that good shit. And I have quite a bit to talk about. All right. So yeah, let's go ahead and get into it. First thing first is, you know, I gotta bring it back because this is going up on YouTube, so I gotta bring back the old school. Sip on that Long Island. All right, now Lego. So first, gonna start off by sending up prayers. Not trying to make this video like a Debbie Downer or anything like that, but Lil Boosie had apparently he has been diagnosed with kidney cancer. I'm not going to say that he has kidney cancer because, like I said, I don't like speaking such things, but he's been diagnosed with kidney cancer. So if we all can, you know, just kind of like wrap our arms around him, you know, well, not necessarily figuratively speaking, but you get what I'm saying. Or even just, you know, lift him up in prayer. So, you know, when you guys do your nightly prayers and whatnot, if you could think about him and, you know, I guess touch and agree and, you know, pray for his healing, his recovery, and all that good jazz. Now, I will say in the Instagram pic where he was asking people to pray for him and shit, you can't be asking for people to sit here and pray for your ass. And you got this big old table full of soul food and nasty food. Not saying that was a contributing factor, but still, you know, just saying. So I want to go ahead and talk about the Chirac trailer. Now, it's no secret that I am from Chicago. And hold on, let me kind of point this fan this way because it's getting a little hot. But it's no secret that I'm from Chicago. And I'm very happy and very proud to be from Chicago. And when I visited this past summer, talked to my cousins and my siblings, you know, because I've been hearing the term Chirac the whole entire time I was in Korea. Well, now Spike Lee is coming out with a video titled Chirac. So, I'm sorry, did I say video? A movie. And I went ahead and I decided, okay, I'm going to check this out. So I went ahead and looked at the trailer. I'm going to be honest, I am not going to fucking watch that shit. And it's for a couple of reasons that I'm not going to watch the Chirac movie. The first reason is I'm not really here for some of the casting. Like, I'm here for parts, but not other parts. Like having, you know, my celebrity wife, Angela Bassett, in there. If it was for anything, I would support her. And also, you have Jennifer Hudson, y'all, and she's from Chicago. And by the previews, it looked like both of them are giving, you know, a good performance. But we got Nick. Now, here's the thing, no shade on Nick Cannon, but we got fucking Nick Cannon. And he's supposed to be one of the lead characters rapping and shit. And then they got a song sitting here, you know, promoting the name Chirac. And where it's like, this is the name of our city. No, motherfuckers, the name of our city is motherfucking Chicago. Let's get that shit straight. And it's one of those ways, it's like, I don't think that it's really going to address the big issues of the violence that's going on in Chicago. Rather than, you know, hey, here's something for him to capitalize on. I don't like shit like that. Like, right now, I'm in fucking North Carolina. I'm, you know, close to Fayetteville. You know, I hit a, you know, whole Fayette. I don't call it that. It's like shit like that you don't do. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, Fayetteville, Fayette, not cool. Chirac, Iraq, you know, like, I got it. A lot of fucked up shit happens in Chicago, but that shit's not cool, you know. I'm definitely not gonna watch Chirac. And if I do watch it, it's not gonna be in theaters. It's not gonna be in theaters. You imply whatever it is that you want to imply, but I will not be watching that shit. Will not. Okay, so some random shit to talk about. And I'm gonna have to sip my drink and hit the vape. Again, I'm taking it back old school. What's up? Ain't shit, you know, like I said, you know, doing the Trending Talk video, talking to y'all, you know, trying to have a good time, you know, sip a little bit, smoke a little bit, talk some shit, you know, what I normally do on Sundays, you know, 1 o'clock p.m. Eastern time, yeah. So, Patti LaBelle and James, a lot has been said about them, and any of y'all that watch me, y'all know there are certain people that I'm team this person. Now, I'm going to call a spade, and I'm going to have to check their ass when I need to check their ass. But y'all know I'm team Patti. Y'all know I'm auntie Patti. You ain't finna sit here, and you not finna go in on motherfucking auntie Patti. That's what you're not going to do. And everybody has their opinions, and I know that. So, of course, she had him over for Thanksgiving dinner. You know, they sung together and whatnot. And a lot of people keep saying, well, she needs to give him money. She needs to do this. She needs to do that. I want to talk about a couple things right quick. Think about the music industry, right? You have artists that unless they have ownership of their royalties and they are if not the executive producer, the only producer, songwriter, and all that stuff, and they're directing their own videos. Well, actually, we're not gonna talk about videos, but just the album itself. If they're not doing all of these things, they can sell many a fucking record and not get a whole lot. Think about TLC. They sold millions of records. And I think the album, which album was it? I think it was Crazy Sexy Cool. If y'all remember, y'all let me know, because I know y'all on here. But I think it was Crazy Sexy Cool that they sold so many fucking albums. But, you know, from when, like, and I'm pretty sure they had a slave contract where everything they were given was ultimately going to be taken out of whatever cut they were going to get at the end. So the artist gets paid dead fucking last. So between the songwriters get, it was certified. Damn. Woo. And damn, they went broke off that motherfucking album. But between, you know, the songwriters being paid, between the producers being paid, paying for studio fees, paying for the videos, and they had some decent, like, not even decent, they, what's up, boo? They had great fucking videos, like Waterfalls, and you think about how the video looked, you know that video costs money to do, you know, touring, like, when you think about everything they had to get paid for, everybody get paid first, the artists get paid last, and that's why they had very little to show for what it is they did. Now, how does this tie into Patti LaBelle? From what I'm understanding, exactly, and that's what I'm trying to get at in bridging the gap with Patti LaBelle. So, it may be her recipe, it may not be her recipe, but when you factor in, you know, publishing, promotion, and all this other stuff, you know, I'm pretty sure of that $2.3 million, a lot of that is already taken away. You also got to factor in taxes, amongst other things. So everybody's saying that she needs to pay him a certain amount. People thinking that that's what she got was $2.3 million. No, y'all. The Pies made $2.3 million. Patti LaBelle did not make that much. I don't know how much she made. And yeah, I'm Team Patti, but still, I really want y'all to follow me with where I'm going with this. Now you have that, right? Now, if she was to go out of her way to say, yes, this individual helped me sell this, he will be owed more than just what she's going to pay him. To a certain extent, they can use that against her, and she would have to, like, pay him a certain percentage. You feel what I'm saying? And think about, you know, well, what's up, Southside? You missed me talking about the Chi-Rod trailer. See, this is what you get for coming in late now. But back to, you know, the topic at hand, more or less, what people are truly feeling around, like, okay, again, YouTube, I do product reviews and whatnot. It doesn't mean that, you know, if, let's just say, 20,000 people watch that video and 20,000 people decide, oh my gosh, I want to go buy that product, it doesn't mean that particular, hold on, wait, they would have hunger for, well, happy belated birthday. And here's the thing, I'm not saying that he should not be given anything, but here's what I'm saying. You know, She hit now, all right now. But what I'm saying is, like, you have people on YouTube that do album reviews, product reviews, amongst other things, and some of them are not being paid to do those particular reviews. Like I said, I'm doing mine. Like I said, I'm still working on reviews and whatnot. I'm not getting paid for those. And if I am getting paid, you'll probably tell by the delivery if I'm actually getting paid for doing the particular shit. But if I sit here and I do an album review for whomever, and, like, let's just say 20,000 people watch that video, right? And of those 20,000, 10,000 go out and buy that person's album because they heard my review, because of how good it was. Does that mean that artist owe me money because of the fact? I understand if it wasn't for that video, yeah, they would have been collecting us. They probably wouldn't have sold anything. But it's one of those where it's just like, he did that out of the kindness of his heart. And do I feel that, you know, Auntie Patty should slap his ass something other than inviting his ass over for Thanksgiving dinner? Yes. But him being a fan, maybe that's all the fuck that he wanted. You feel what I'm saying? I mean, that's all that I'm saying. I'm not saying that she owes him anything, but it's no different than people doing product reviews and everything else. If that shit sells, it does not necessarily mean that that person is entitled to anything, but a good act would be to go ahead and, you know, break him off a piece of that Kit Kat bar. Now, I'm finna go ahead and take a sip, and I'm finna sit here and blow the vape in y'all face. Y'all let me know how y'all feel, because y'all know when I'm team somebody, I'ma say what the fuck I gotta say. Yeah, put his ass on the payroll now. Yeah. Hold on. I understand the whole giving credit where credit is due, but again, if she were to do that, I'm not saying that it will hold up in court, but if she says that, yes, it is because of him that this sold and yada, 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 and blah, 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 she could, you know, pretty much back herself into a corner and be forced to pay. That's all that I'm saying. You know, I mean, it's no different. You know what? I think we all can agree to disagree. All right, I'm glad somebody gets my point about the whole Patty, you know, about, you know, Auntie Patty. But do I feel that she should break his ass off some dough? Yeah, on some real motherfucking shit. But what I will say is, I respect the fact that James is, you know, being reserved and not sitting here and hearing what everybody is saying and losing his everlasting mind, because this can destroy his brand. Now, what I will say is he needs to capitalize on this shit. You know, one, try to at least, here's the first foremost, if T Spelling was at Pat LaBelle house and shit, I would have been like, Patty bitch, you need to go ahead and talk to Walmart, go ahead and put me in the motherfucking commercial, okay? Break me off a little bit of this motherfucking money. Give me some shit on this motherfucking commercial. We go ahead and put these pies on motherfucking blast for motherfucking Christmas and shit, Jesus' birthday and shit, the motherfucking New Year and shit. Let's go ahead and do that now. And I mean, we can call this shit even Steven. You know what I'm saying? Pitch that shit. But use this opportunity to go ahead, get on YouTube. If he doesn't already have YouTube, I'm not sure if he does, because if I'm not mistaken, he uploaded this to Facebook. Get on YouTube, sing his ass off, try to fight for a record deal, shit, holla at Auntie Pappy, like, bitch, if you ain't gonna give me no money, try to hook a motherfucker up with a record deal, shit, you know what I'm saying, just something, but ride this way. I mean, because, you know, again, everybody get those 15 minutes, and not everybody is like Missy Elliott. Quick tangent, everybody said when Missy Elliott came out and stole, yeah, that boy can sing. When Missy Elliott came and sold a halftime performance away from motherfucking Katy Perry's, I might have to talk about that shit on a different motherfucking day, because I ain't like how motherfuckers was stupid and shit. Everybody said, and I even said, she should have came out with an album, like, right the fuck then. Like, at least 10 of her songs was in, like, the top 10 on motherfucking iTunes. Exactly. And, you know, but here's the thing, even though she didn't do that, thank you so much for sharing that. Even though she didn't do that, she just came out with, you know, WTF. And that motherfucking song is doing fucking bananas right now. Not everybody can be like Missy Elliott and have that window open, but still come out with something and still shine. But again, it's Missy Misdemeanor Elliott. You know what I'm saying? So what I'm saying is that he really needs to ride this. thank y'all so much for sharing this on Twitter. Share this with y'all people. Let them come on over, because I got more shit to talk about. Okay, I got more shit. So, I think I'm done with talking about Auntie Patty. I think we all done talked about this enough and shit. So, let's go ahead and talk about when you have to sit here. She can make it. Yeah, she can. She can sit here and she can, you know, sit here and purr on a motherfucker. Thank you so much, James, for sharing that. Yeah, she can purr on a motherfucking album. She can sit here on a motherfucking album and that motherfucking shit sell. Hell, I'm just saying, basically that girl. Okay, like I said, shit, when Lil Kim did a cover of Ladies Night, and I think it was called Not Tonight, you know, she ain't even rap hard. She was like, oh, what a night. You should be like me instead of being like my. Like, she had just a couple of bars and a little bit of an ad-lib. And I think she sang the chorus, too, but didn't really do a whole lot. Come on now, Missy. Come on now. Oh, yeah, she can collab with any motherfucking body, okay? I'm hoping that I can retire talking about Auntie Patty and Negative Life, but let's move on now. Not everybody on here have siblings. I know I have siblings, you know, like I said, I have a brother I never met, a sister I never met, and shit. Again, daddy was a Rolling Stone. Ain't no motherfucking serious shit. Everybody in my family already fucking knowing shit. But sometimes when your family get to talking too motherfucking much, sometimes you just gotta nut the fuck up on their ass, right? So, we all know Chris Rock, and he has a little thing going where he's not claiming, I believe, this adopted African daughter or young lady that he and his, I believe, soon-to-be ex-wife has. I'm kind of fuzzy on everything that's going on with them, but he's not claiming this young girl to not pay child support, where Tony Rock, his motherfucking brother, this motherfucker got loose, motherfucker, this motherfucker then went to fucking damn TMZ and up and said that, you know, Chris was trying to bring her in and give her a better motherfucker. Why the fuck would you open your motherfucking mouth? That ain't got shit to do with you. If a motherfucker come, like, let's just say for motherfuckingness is my ass blow the fuck up and shit. If that shit happened, I would be fucking floored, I'm not gonna lie. But if that shit was to ever happen, I would have to sit all my motherfucking family down and shit. 11, God, whew. But I would have to sit everybody down and be like, look, bitches, all of y'all, if any motherfucking body asks you any motherfucking question about this motherfucker right here, you don't say shit, okay? You don't say not a damn motherfucking thing. I don't give a fuck if they ask you, you know, does your brother masturbate on the motherfucker regular? You don't say shit. That, you don't say not a damn thing. Don't ask not one damn motherfucking question. Don't nothing, okay? Talk about your damn self. Shit. But the fact that he had up and opened his mouth, that could fuck Chris up in the long run. Now, again, I don't know everything that's going on with this motherfucking case, but I'm mad at his motherfucking brother because you got loose motherfucking lips, man. Like, that's some shit. Here's the thing, y'all. I'm finna be honest. I'm a motherfucker. I will cut a motherfucker off quick, fast, in a motherfucking hurry. Like I said, if any... Like I said, like, if any of y'all ever get a chance to run into any of my family, they will tell you, Yarrell will go years without talking to a motherfucker. Yarrell will sit up and act like you don't motherfucking exist. If you call me anything but Yarrell, and there's only a select few didn't call me anything other than that, I'm going to pretend like you don't fucking exist until you address me by my motherfucking government name. Like, I'm that motherfucking dude. I done cut motherfuckers off pretend. Not even pretend. Bitch, you don't exist in my motherfucking life. With that shit be, and when I say don't exist, and I'm going to do a separate video, wait till December, I'm going to talk about when I came home Jewish, my Dukes almost got cut the fuck off. I love my Dukes. I really do. Actually, I'm going to do two videos because she almost got cut off twice. I'm just saying. But it's just like, you loose lips, I don't like that shit. You feel what I'm saying? And I will cut you off, because my whole thing is this. You know what? I'm done talking about Tony and Chris. Look, here's my whole motherfucking thing. When it comes to happiness and joy, if keeping you in my life for the sake of the title of this is my mother, this is my father, this is my brother, this is my sister, this is my friend, if keeping you in my life is gonna cause me more pain and misery than the motherfucker, yes, my dudes, than the motherfucking joy that I am seeking after, I'ma cut your motherfucking ass off, because I only got one life to live, and I will be damned if holding on to your cancerous motherfucking ass is gonna sit here. No, what I'ma do is I will remove the motherfucking cancer, and I'ma go the I'm sorry. Cause I done made this shit about me. I'm finna move the fuck on ya. I'm sorry. I done got too damn excited. Gotta tell him now. Alright, so I'm gonna go ahead and talk about something right quick. Preach, bro. And then I'm gonna move on to a little bit of Real Housewives of Atlanta talk. So apparently Stevie Wonder has cut off the braids. And I know people, you know, are clapping up and everything. And, I mean, it's one of those things where it's just like, bruh, you know shit, do what the fuck you do. I mean, I guess he didn't see that his motherfucking hairline was receiving, but, I mean, it is what the fuck it is. So, I'm gonna go ahead and move right into a little bit of Real Housewives of, yeah, the vape, yeah, it's back. A little bit of the Real Housewives of Atlanta. Now, what I'm about to talk about is not necessarily Real Housewives of Atlanta, the Real Households, by the way. I'm doing a review tonight, and real quick, I know Nate Love and Erica De Niro are not on here, but I'm repping the shirt. Come on, bitch. It's going to be in the motherfucking video tonight. Y'all already, yes, the hoes, the Atlanta hoes. But I had to, I'm rocking the shirt. I had to find, had to dust the bitch off, because I've been looking for the motherfucker. So for every motherfucking Real Housewives of Atlanta video that I do, okay, that I do, you gotta go see Steven. I'm wearing the motherfucking shirt. And again, it's all about support. You feel what I'm saying? So shit, when Erica put on her thing that this shirt was available, when I say with the quickness I bought the motherfucker, okay, shout out to Justin J. Faster than this, I went ahead and purchased that motherfucker. So, the Real Housewives of Atlanta. Now, y'all know there are three individual people that I have never fucking saw it for, and we all can agree to this a fucking agree, okay? But there were three people I never saw it for. Person number one is NeNe Leakes. I liked her in the first season. Yeah, I love them. I love them separately, but when they together, oh my gosh, I love they has. And again, I'll be waiting for that whole, come on, bitch, I'll be waiting for it. I fucking love them. But NeNe Leakes, I liked her in the very beginning. But when the shit started to get to her head, I wasn't quite feeling it. Again, I'm gonna give a whole props what props is due. You know, kudos to her. She in Chicago, but I'm going to have to refill that damn cup shit. Person number one. Person number two is the queen of Thotlandia, Portia Williams. Here's the thing. I didn't see it for the... Here's the thing. Let me say this. When I say Portia, and I'm going to be nice and say her real name, she is a very, very beautiful woman. She really is. She's very gorgeous, very attractive. When I say her head be laid and that body be stashed, it does. I'm gonna give props where the fuck is due. And I think that she plays the fucking dumb role. Cause I can't believe. Well, actually, no, it is motherfuckers that motherfucker dumb though. But I can't believe she this damn dumb. But I don't fucking like her. I don't. I can't stand it. I don't see it for. And then the main motherfucker that I'm is fake Drew Parks. And that's the hoe I'm about to talk about. But in talking about this hoe, I'm not talking about another motherfucker swinging on a pole hoe. This is talking about that hoe, which is going to bring us into a pie hoe. So, there's this former dancer. I believe her name is Kashawn Sydney. She wrote a book pretty much talking about all these celebrity men that she done slept with. Which I'm just like, okay. And it's one of those where it's like, make your money how you got to make it. But at the same exact time, on some real shit... Talking about loose lips. depending on who the fuck name she drops in this damn fucking book, all I'm gonna say is I wish no harm to her. But y'all know how motherfuckers be, and it's so easy to be like, I'm not finna touch you, but I'm finna make a motherfucking phone call, and your ass about to disappear so you don't see shit. You feel what I'm saying? Yeah, them households, not them households. And right quick, if y'all have not, before I finish this, go ahead and share this on Twitter and share this with all those that follow you on Periscope. Let's bring their asses over here. But she revealed in this book that she has slept with Apollo Nida. And I'm finna go ahead and finish drinking this, and I'm about to pour another one, because this shit ain't good. But she done slept, if y'all want, I got this shit pre-motherfucking made. But she done slept with Apollo. But not only did she sleep with Apollo, no. It gets better, y'all. She slept with Apollo. Thank you so much, for sharing that. So predictive. Appreciate you. Not only did she sleep with Apollo, okay? She slept with Apollo in Apollo's house. But not only did she sleep with Apollo in Apollo. What's up, Quintessentia? Not only did she sleep with Apollo in Apollo's house, she slept with Apollo in Apollo's bedroom. I'm sorry, in his children's bedroom. Not only did she sleep with the motherfucker in the bedroom, she slept with the motherfucker on one of the kids' motherfucking beds. Well, here's the thing. You know what? I'ma say this. Kudos to motherfucking Apollo. Apollo done went from fucking a bitch on a motherfucking mattress to fucking a bitch on his child's bed. Go ahead, Apollo. I mean, go ahead. Upgrade. She done upgraded his ass. Went from a motherfucking air mattress that fucking fake truck put the hoe on to fucking on the motherfucking kid's bed. Go ahead. Go ahead. And if y'all are wondering who this person is, her name is the person that allegedly screwed Apollo. Her name is Kashan, spelled C-A-S-H-A-U-N, Sydney. And she has a book out. Yes, let me upgrade you. But apparently you can get the book on Kindle. I'm not finna buy that shit. I mean, I'm all about a motherfucker making their coins and shit. I just hope she don't come up missing. When you do shit like this, you run the risk of losing your life by sitting here. Here's the thing. I know my moniker, note to the book, is, well, actually, the moniker of my YouTube station is Spilling All the Tea. My moniker in general is Tea Spilling. But I have a limit on how much tea I'ma spill, and I'm not finna lose my life over trying to sit here and give y'all some life now. What you mean I shot off with this fake in Apollo? Whoa, long. And this fake draw in Apollo, but whoa, long. I'ma need for you, Miss So Predictive, to kinda clarify what it is you saying to me. I'm trying to figure out what you were saying. This ain't no tea party. right quick. So, but then please go ahead and clarify, because I got some love and hip hop umbrella to talk about, because so much shit didn't happen with motherfucking love and hip hop, and our this afternoon tea is hot. Well, if it's hot for you, you know, again, like I said, thank you, Sir Merch. But for everybody, go ahead and share this. I mean, bring some people over here. Because on some real shit, when this is done, I'm going to immediately transcribe this. And once it's done transcribing, it will no longer be on Periscope. And they're going to have to find it on YouTube. Thank you so much, Quintessential. Thank you so much. Appreciate it. Now, let's go ahead and get into this love and hip hop talk. And I'm going to jump around a little bit. So I'm finna take y'all asses from Hollywood slightly to New York wannabe. Cynthia Peter cheated, huh? Alright, hold the fuck. Whoa, okay, first and foremost, First of all, okay, hold on now. Let me first, I need to write some down. Sin and Peter cheating. And first of all, let me go ahead and say this right quick. Right quick. For the whole Moniece thing, if y'all are not privy, y'all know I have mucus buildup. It's fucking bad. I hate it. If you don't know, I am Team Moniece. I am in the process of developing a logo for my Team Moniece t-shirts. I think only a couple people might want to buy it, but when Love & Hip Hop Hollywood come back pending, sexy ass Moniece bring her ass back. Here go James. Right, here we go. You already know. Hey, I gotta sit here and represent for my boo, baby. Cause I'ma talk about Love & Hip Hop right quick. I'ma talk about Cynthia and Peter, then I'ma come back to Love & Hip Hop. But let me talk about my boo. Let me talk about my boo, Moniece. Now I got to talk about my boo. First off, I'ma rep Moniece. Okay, I am Team Motherfucking Moniece day of the motherfucking week. Okay. But here's the thing, because everybody wants to sit here and compare motherfuckers to Mariah Carey. First and foremost, let me sit here and say, even if we talk about Mariah from her prime, even though to an extent Mariah is quote unquote that bitch, she is not quote unquote that bitch. And here's why I say that. Oh, I know the heart's from the stop, but on some real shit. Yes, I'm crushing them on these. Yes, I am. Yes, the fuck I am. Thank you, Faye. Sister One for Shane. Yes, I'm crushing on these hard. Okay. Like I said, I think I can sit here and tame the beast that is motherfucking Moniece, but let me say this. There are many of women that can sit here and destroy Mariah Carey. And I'm not even trying to motherfucking be funny. If we gonna sit here and talk about the motherfucking whistle register, even though everybody wants to clown, hold on, wait. Hold the fuck on now. Hold on. I have not heard Moniece sing to her. Oh, shit. My sister up in this bitch. What's up, Lika? But hold the fuck on. I have not heard Moniece sing to her full capability. But what I will say is if we push Moniece out the picture ever so slightly. What's up, boo? What's up, sis? Hold the fuck on. Let me hit this vape right quick. I got some shit to say because y'all done got a motherfucking start. Straight old school. There are many motherfucking women who have a fucking whistle register that are stronger than motherfucking Mariah. And I'm talking about Mariah before she went, I don't know what the fuck she did. The main motherfucker that can sit here and shit on motherfucking Mariah with the fucking whistle is the motherfucking R&B motherfucking LA bitch. There we go. You the guy already. Motherfucking Shantae Moore. She can do it too. There are many fucking people that can sit here and hit a motherfucking whistle. Shantae will sit here and whistle on your ass. What I would do is if I am not too drunk when I'm done with this shit and when this shit motherfucking upload on y'all asses, I will sit here. Man, fuck her 19. I'm not trying to be all but I'ma sit here and show y'all a video, not of when she did it on R&B Divas. She sat here and did It's All Right and for at least 4 motherfucking minutes. Not only did she hit a whistle on your ass, she went up some motherfucking levels on that motherfucking whistle. Y'all miss me with that motherfucking Mariah shit. We not finna do it. We not finna do it. Okay? We not finna fucking do it. And if we gonna sit here, hold on. But we gonna sit here and talk about some motherfuckers that can sit here and sing to the motherfucking Raptors. If y'all don't know, if you don't know about Miss Lisa Fisher, y'all need, even though she dropped one motherfucking album, even though she sung backup for motherfucking Luther Vandross, What other motherfuckers, it's many of motherfuckers that done won a motherfucking Grammy. First album around, she sat here, and not only did she win a Grammy on her, yes, she did that shit. Did she win a Grammy on her first motherfucking record? She and Miss Auntie Patty, hold on now, I'm getting excited. They tied for fucking R&B motherfucking vocalist. Come on, Jazz, run them damn receipts. What I'm saying is, it's other motherfucking people that can sing to the motherfucking Raptors. Y'all not finna come on here with that Mariah shit. Now, let me not get it. Don't get the shit twisted. I like Mariah. But y'all not finna come over here and do that. And what you're not gonna do, you not finna sit here and shade my boo. Motherfucking Monique, we not doing that today. We not doing that today. So I'm gonna leave this alone for a quick minute. Oh, Shanice can do that shit. Shit. here's the thing. Tangent. When I say I love music, and shit, my sister, Lady Nika, can prove this to y'all. Yarrell, spilling all the tea, whatever the fuck you know me by, will tell you, I love some good motherfucking music, y'all. Okay, I love me some good music. When I say music, I'm talking about, you know, Gladys Knight with the Pips, Earth, Wind, and motherfucking Fire and shit. You know what I'm saying? Faker, Beverly, and Maze, Al Green. Y'all know how I love some motherfucking Teddy Pendergrass. I'm about to say Teddy Pendergrass down, but that's T-Pain. I love music. Luther Vandross, Lennon motherfucking Williams. Like, I love good motherfucking shit. Jaguars, that bitch too. I love good motherfucking music. So when I sit here and get passionate, I'm talking about the motherfuckers that then came and fucking did it. I love fucking acapellas and shit. The Boys to Men, the fucking Shies, the Silks, you know what I'm saying? The Satins, if y'all don't know about the Satins, y'all fucking sleeping. The motherfucking Temptations and shit. Oh, y'all, they ain't ready for Sade. They ain't ready. They ain't ready. Sade will have you jump out your motherfucking drawers and pants. Y'all ain't ready for Sade. Throw a curb. Third curveball, James. Shit, we done went from Trinity Thomas to me. Go ahead. Ooh, shit, bitch. Hold on, Jesse Powell. That song, you, that motherfucker, that's my motherfucking wedding song. Okay, when I come down the motherfucking aisle, that's my shit. All I'm saying is this. Okay. I know about music, but we gonna leave the music alone right now. We gonna leave the music alone because I'm gonna get in my motherfucking feelings and shit. I'm Team Moniece all motherfucking day long on that ass. And I'm gonna come back to talk about Team Moniece and shit, okay? So, for someone that asked me about Cynthia and Peter cheating, let me say this. I believe that Cynthia and Peter have took some acting classes. Nigga, I'm Team Moniece all but have you not watched my videos? Okay. I need a motherfucking review on that bullshit ass good lotion motherfucking video and shit. And I went the fuck in because of how the fuck they did Moniece. We all know Moniece got buck motherfucking bags under her motherfucking eyes. How the fuck you gonna sit here and request her to be in your motherfucking video, but you showed all them motherfucking bags? I was so motherfucking, hold on. Y'all real, calm the fuck down, hold on. You know what? I don't think they sold their marriage to Bravo, but I think this. If y'all go back to the motherfucking reunion and shit. I forget who the fuck it was, but it was Horsha. Horsha was sitting here trying to tell her, well, you need to worry about your husband sleeping with motherfucking waitresses and shit. Cynthia ain't no dumb bitch. She ain't no dumb hoe. She was just, I'm not going to bet my paycheck and shit because I need my motherfucking money now. Okay, I need my money. But I'm pretty fucking sure she probably sat with her motherfucking husband just like, you know what the fuck to do. Yes, whore shit. She's a fucking whore. Okay? Because I'm not believing her motherfucking storyline. Peter is silly. Yeah, it's fake. Horse's storyline fake too. I'm trying to be motherfucking nice with these motherfucking hoes. But you know what? I'm talk about some shit. I'm going to talk about some shit. Hold the fuck on. But. For her to sit here and say that, I'm pretty sure she sat here and told Peter, you know what, go ahead, do some scandalous shit. And we're going to sit here and we're going to make this our motherfucking storyline. Because if y'all see the way that this shit is looking, Cynthia is about to be the motherfucking MVP of this motherfucking season next to Kenya Moore. If y'all fucking peeping the motherfucking shit and here's the thing, when Peter cried them up, I was trying to be reserved on the video, not spilling shit. But when he fucking cried them motherfucking tail, I'm like, you better do that shit, Uncle Ben. You better do that shit, motherfucking Patricia. You better, come on now. Come the fuck on through with them motherfucking on the spot motherfucking tears and shit I was so fucking here for. And the fact that I really do believe, hold on. It is what the fuck it is. I'm not really an Instagram hoe. I am a hoe, okay? I'm not an Instagram hoe, but you know, it is what it, but what I will say is, I think that she even pimped out her own motherfucking sister, pretty much. Make you believe, baby. Come on, nigga. But I think that with all the shit that was going on, that she even knew that Mallory is a salty bitch. That Mallory will sit here and give her what she need. And I think that is probably why she said what the fuck she said. When I was watching that motherfucking scene, it brought back Toni Braxton on that ass. She saucy, you know. Seven whole nights. That whole, I'm not finna say for y'all that I've been drinking. But seven whole days, seven whole nights on that ass, y'all. But it was 10 days. But that's that whole shit. That's what I feel about their damn relationship. And even though Peter did a video saying he doesn't like that their relationship has been the focus of this season, that right there fucking lets you know. Oh, she a bit of bitch. She a bit of bitch. She is. Pretty sure her motherfucking husband is sitting here been slanging dick on every bitch but her motherfucking ass. But she got a trophy motherfucking husband. We already know. But the fact that she pretty much went ahead and said that, Patricia's a motherfucker. She said that he's upset, she's upset, whatever, that this has been the storyline, further putting gasoline on the motherfucking flames, and we here for the shit. We gonna watch the shit. You feel what I'm saying? So, come on through Cynthia and Patricia, and I'm done with them. But that's all I'm fucking going to talk about with the motherfucking households. Back to love and hippity hop. Let's talk about, actually, before I talk, I'm going to ask you guys a question. I'm going to sip on my tea, and then I'm going to hit my fade. You know what? Here's the thing, on most of these shows they fake it for a check, but what I will say is this. You do what you gotta do. They on a reality show, they gonna make their motherfucking money. But here's a question. It's a question I have for y'all. Between these two individuals, based off what we've seen on Love and Hip Hop Hollywood, we're gonna talk with Hollywood right now, and what we've seen on the blogs, thank y'all so much for the hearts. I really do appreciate it. Who is the bigger bitch? Is it Miles or is it Milan? And I'm finna sip in and I'll vape on y'all ass. But y'all let me know, who is the bigger bitch? Hot damn! Really, James, it's you? Hot damn, everybody saying Milan. What I'm drinking? Okay, what? Who is it? Breeze is 7821. Before I answer, for all of y'all watching and y'all that watch me faithfully, she asked me what I'm drinking. Can y'all let Breeze Can y'all let her know, or him, I don't know, but I'm pretty sure it's a her. Let her know what I'm drinking. Okay. I'm a pause for a second because it's obvious. It's obvious what it is that I'm drinking. And it's some strong shit. That's right. It's that tea, baby. That Long Island Iced tea on your ass that will put you on your ass. Well, I will say this. Equally, I think they both are some big ass bitches. Now, I don't follow the shit that they do on social media. I try to stay away from that because I don't want to sit here and have to constantly talk about them on my fucking trending topic. You gonna shake the foundation? Oh, some real shit. I would say this. If they want a motherfucker that shakes... First, oh, James, right quick. I done said this many a motherfucking time. You... Niggas, sit your ass down. Niggas, sit your ass down. You always sit here talking about some throwing in the motherfucking circle. Now you want to see it be a sidekick. Sit your ass down. But if I'm done with this certain part of my life, and y'all know what I do for a living, y'all know the two jobs, but are combined into one. We're not gonna talk about it on here. You can't. Yes, you can. But if they had a Love & Hip Hop Chicago, they could put my ass on Love & Hip Hop Chicago. I'ma show y'all how the fuck you get the shit done. I'ma show your ass better than I can motherfucking tell your ass. They went with a boot. Well, here's the thing now. I haven't been following everything, but apparently. You know what? Here's the thing. Mona not ready for Chicago. She ain't ready. Because she's going to all these other places to where her crew not in danger. If she go to motherfucking Chicago, especially in the motherfucking underground to motherfucking K-Town and shit. You feel what I'm saying? Like to the motherfucking gutters and shit. Her crew might get motherfucking shot on the motherfucking scenes, but that will be some of the realest shit. You ain't even gotta sit here and come up with a motherfucking storyline. Oh, the Wild Hunt. Wait, if we do the Wild Hunters now, you know the Wild Hunters not really Chicago though. But if you go and you do a motherfucking Love & Hip Hop Chicago, you don't need no storylines. Bitch, Chicago is your damn storyline. Okay? I'm just saying. Yes, it is. She ain't ready for the shot. She ain't fucking. What I'm saying is, you do Love & Hip Hop Chicago, it's gonna be the highest fucking ratings. Okay, not Inglewood. Not Inglewood. Don't nobody want to see New Jack City. New Jack City ain't got shit on Chicago. I'm trying to tell y'all asses. Go to fucking Chicago. And I'm talking about do a real, legit Love & Hip Hop Chicago. It will be the highest fucking ratings that she has. Wait a minute. What? Oh, okay. You know what? All right, wait a minute. I'm going to let you have it. It is Chicago. I'm going to let you have it. What I'm saying is this. You do Love & Hip Hop Chicago. And have them let go and let they ass fight. I'm fucking telling your ass, you got some shit on your motherfucking hands. What you mean you try to, Lady Nick, boo boo, you trying to get on my? We ain't gonna Hyde Park. Oh, no tea, no shade. Got the Jews and shit. I'm Jewish and shit. If I go back to Chicago to live, I'm going to Hyde Park. But you on Van. Okay. Dick riding. That's all I'm going to say. And now I'm going to call how the fuck it is on this shit. You know what? James, stop it. Stop it. Anyway, because I done lost some focus. Hold on. I know. We're back to Milan. So apparently, I can't read right now. I gotta finish with it. We gonna be on here for well over an hour fucking with y'all. But he met with, if I'm not mistaken, I think it was the Shade Room. And you know, shout outs to them. Like I said, I get content from them. Media Takeout, Bossip, Raps with Snitch. That's where I get a lot of this content from. But he met with them. And I'm going to talk about some shit that he done said and shit. Okay, Miles a bitch too, though. And I'm only saying that because I can see it in them, but I haven't been following their fucking relationship and shit on social media. But if I did, I could just do a video itself on how big of a bitch both of their ass is. But anyway, and I'm going to sit here and say, Milan a bitch ass motherfucker, but just wait for... So, he says that he... why y'all say shit? No, I'm not gonna do that. Anyway, he says he and Hazel, Clown Manny, they are not besties because she is posting pics with his ex. If you guys remember watching Love and Hip Hop Hollywood, what you will see is you will see her even talking to Miles. And trying to talk to the son bitch, even though we know this shit was contrived like a motherfucker. But I'm going to say this. Even if your ass is best buzz with a motherfucker, I'm grown. Okay? I'm not going to give y'all my government name, but Yarrell is grown. T. Spillin is grown. Duran is grown. Arctic is grown. Tech is grown. High Speed is grown. Okay? I got many motherfucking nicknames in this bitch. I'm grown, okay? Me and all my motherfucking personalities, all of our asses. And in 2016, you guys will get to meet all my damn personalities. Wait for that shit. But we grown. Here's the thing, shit. If you... Now, it's seldom when I won't fuck with a motherfucker. Because they ain't fucking with a friend. Now, y'all know Lady Nigga, that's my sister. I love her. I really do. We talked on the regular, okay? And shit, she gets me together, I gets her together. Shit, if I did a video on the nicknames that my black ass has, y'all gonna be like, what the fuck? But, like I said, we love each other. We gets each other together. You feel what I'm saying? I love you too. But what I'm getting at is, I'm just gonna talk about some real shit. I don't give a fuck. I might lose subscribers, but it is what the fuck it is. I done lost several. I done lost like 4 subscribers since I've been back. But for every subscriber that I lost, shit, I done gained like 2 on y'all asses. I'm gonna just talk right quick. You know, sis, I'm gonna speak. Don't get mad at what I'm about to say. She was beefing, and I'm gonna just not really beefing, but I'm gonna just say this shit. Fucking, what's that whole name? I can't, you know what, because I'm not subscribed from the whole. But, this one individual, and her name probably gonna go to my head. It's gonna come to me. CD Mitchell, that's the whole. A fucking YouTuber who ain't doing shit fucking decided that she was gonna sit here and be messing motherfucking boots on that ass. Shout out to motherfucking it's not Love of Hip Hop, it's Quad from Married to Medicine. Messing boots and shit. That she gonna sit here and take her motherfucking ass to CD Mitchell and say, hey, guess what? This person is using your motherfucking title, even though ain't nobody stealing shit from no motherfucking body. Ain't no motherfucker sitting here grabbing nobody motherfucking coattail and shit. Now, I talked to, you know, my sister, I talked to Nika. And it was one of which, like, I feel where you coming from. But at the same exact time, I'm going to try to be nice. And I'm going to support this motherfucker. If y'all saw a Periscope I did way the fuck back when, I went the fuck off. And then somebody from YouTube decided they was going to sit here and ask a question. Who the fuck it is? And if you know who you are and you watching this, you know who the fuck you were. And I said who the fuck it is. And then she's like, y'all trying to sit here and get her off YouTube. Ain't nobody trying to fucking do shit. You feel what the fuck I'm saying? But what the fuck I did say is if anybody decide they want to fucking be messy and sit... Jay, stop it. But I'm like, if any of y'all decide that what the fuck y'all want to do is sit here and tag her in this shit and she come to fuck over here and her or her motherfucking son motherfucking decide to say anything to a motherfucking hoe, I guarantee you, T Spillin, Yarrell, this motherfucker right here, I'ma bury your motherfucking ass. I ain't here for the fucking fuck shit, but what the fuck I will, because here's the thing, when it come to my motherfucking channel, people talk shit, I don't say shit. Lady Nika, she on here, and she will verify. There was a motherfucker, last, she will tell you, a motherfucker, and I believe her moniker was Soul of a Woman, I don't give a fuck, came for her. And I believe the bitch was coming for me, but came for her. Lady Nika would tell you, I got on her channel. Not only did I sit here and read the motherfucker for filth, what the fuck I did is I intellectually and spiritually read that motherfucking ad. Here's the thing, you come on my channel and say whatever the fuck you want to say. Why? Because the fam will sit here and take care of your ass. I ain't got time for you. I'm not finna come over my motherfucking throne and relinquish my crown to say shit. But when the fuck I see your ass come for one of my motherfucking family members and shit, yeah, exactly why. But if I see you coming for my motherfucking family, you best believe I'ma get your ass together so much. I will wrap your ass like a motherfucking Christmas, even though I'm celebrating. A Christmas motherfucking present. I will get your ass a fuck together. Whew. I think I done lost track of what the fuck I was saying, though. I really did. I remember what I was saying. But what I was saying is this. Her and CeeDee Mitchell had their motherfucking issues, right? I was still supporting this hoe. But when I started to see that there was so much motherfucking venom and nastiness in her, when I say with the quickness, I unsubscribed from her, I did. Because my whole thing is this. I do believe that as black people, you know, I'm talking to my melanated people right now, we should try to support each other through whatever. You feel what I'm saying? I feel you now. I do. I feel you. I went ahead and I was trying to support through the bullshit. But when I started to see all the shit that she was talking, and James know what I'm talking about, done. Motherfucking done. But back to Milan and, well, just Milan ass right now. Yeah, that's who the fuck I'm talking about. Motherfucking CeeDee Mitchell. Here's the thing, I ain't motherfucking ashamed to say shit. When I'm done with this motherfucking video, this bitch going to motherfucking YouTube, I don't give a motherfucking fuck. I don't care. You know what I'm saying? I know you told me, Nika, okay? I know. You know what, James? I fucking feel you, though. I'm about to put myself in a motherfucking drink because I'm going to fuck two in right now. But back to Milan. Milan whole thing is, because, you know, I'm beaming this and third, and me and Miles ain't together, I don't know why you posting pictures this and third. That's some bitch shit right there. That's some bitch ass shit right there. I got it at first. I was still trying to stay in the mind frame of support, okay? I like to support people, okay? I know you don't bother nobody, but I know you will get a bitch, a hoe, and everybody in between ass together. Let me pour another drink on y'all asses. Pour another drink. I didn't. Nika, don't do that. But you know what? When I'm done with this video, I'ma call you because you try to sit here and shade my ass on Periscope and shit. I'ma call you after this, okay? You know what? I'm going to say, it's one of those things where it's just like, you know, she is an older woman. My whole thing is this. You're going to have your opinions on people and shit. And I understand. I really do. I'm going to call the shit. I'm going to call your ass when this shit over. Man, fuck that shit. Back to Love & Hip Hop. Because y'all doing too much here. So, he mad. He pissed at, you know, Hazel for that. My whole thing is this. Because he trying to sit here and lie and talking about some people saying they didn't want to film me because I was gay was bullshit. But who the only motherfucker that was really filming with your bitch ass this whole motherfucking time? Moving the fuck on. Now, Miles talk about, I'm sorry, not Miles. Milan talk about Miles' arrest. Now, it's one of those where, okay, I guess I can see that. And he comes with receipts. I was 50-50. Like, you know, I was half and half with it. It was just like, if you don't talk about the shit, huh? Again, mucus. I fucking hate this mucus in my chest. If you don't talk about the shit, how I received at the same exact time, the fact that you want to go overboard to talk about this shit, you didn't have to fucking do that. You hate her presence on the show. I am assuming you are talking about, are we talking about Milan or are we talking about Hazel? And you know what you got? All right, look. I know this is very, very unprofessional. Give me like 30 to 45 seconds. I'll be right back. Hold the fuck on. Had to take care of some business. It was either that or in this damn video. I wasn't trying to do that, okay? But, you know, and here's the thing. In the video he had with the Shade Room, I didn't mind him coming with receipts, but it seemed like he was over fucking reaching. And I didn't fucking like that. You know what? To an extent, I feel bad for Hazel. But can I talk? Can we talk for a minute? Can we talk for a minute, y'all? I'm asking y'all, on some real shit, can we talk? Y'all let me know if we can talk. I want to know if we can talk. Here's my thing with Hazel. Damn, fuck Hazel. Oh, shit. Now, look, lady nigga type this, but wait to send it until I finish my statement. Because I want you to tell me why you hate her. But, my thing is this. I lost so much respect for motherfucking Hazel because you sitting here and you clapping. You sitting here motherfucking clapping when you know that Tierra was fresh with her fucking surgery and shit, right, bitch? But when she come and text your ass like, I'm about to crash your shit, you run with your motherfucking tail tucked between your motherfucking legs and shit. Like, I respect the fact that you weren't trying to get gutted with a motherfucker, but you ran? You ran for the motherfucking hills and shit? Exactly, James Scare, biatch, you ran? Now, nigga, tell me why you don't like her. Let me know. She a simple bitch. Right quick, James, I'm talking to you, pimpin'. Did I not tell you that Love and Hip Hop was going to take up most of this? And I ain't even got to the other shit yet. I ain't got to the other shit yet. Like, Love and Hip Hop taking over most of this shit. She a bugger with a win. I would have to ask you and Alexander Rogers. I love both of y'all. Y'all need to stop. Because I'm coming for your ass. Ooh, yes. Okay. Back to the trending topics, you guys. So, he said that being a man. All right. So, we all know that Miles was arrested because he put hands on Milan, right? So, he said, before I finish this, you guys, what I want you guys to do, if you have not already done it, I'm going to say this like several times through the video. If you guys have not done this, share this Periscope on your Twitter. Share this with all of those that watch you on Periscope. Let's get their ass sick. We having too much damn fun but to only be currently 12 of us. Because I got more shit. When I say I got more shit, y'all see these damn cards. Thank you so much, lady nigga. I got cards and shit. Thank y'all so much. Thank y'all. Y'all invited me. Thank you. But he was pretty much saying that, you know, he did this shit with a thank you, Mark Anthony, 504. Was saying that you know, the whole restraint order and everything, right? So with all of that, you'll find out, okay, well, James, if you gotta go, that's fine, but you know this video gonna be up on YouTube. Well, it's going to be on replay, but it's going to YouTube shortly after. And once I'm done transcribing, it's going straight to YouTube. I need for y'all to watch that now. But, good up, James. But what I didn't like is he was saying that because he is a man, he would have walked him like a dog. I'm going to pause right there. Now, I'm not going to pause, but hint that. But he said because he was so in love with him and everything, he just called the Pope. Now, you saying that you, hold on, wait, you know what? My lips start to get chapped. Y'all already know if y'all watch me. Y'all know I feel chapped lips ain't sexy, hold on. What he said was when Miles put his hands on him, and I didn't know that Milan was short as fuck. I ain't fucking know that shit until I saw the motherfuckers. He's been now like he's short as shit. But but yeah, put the bomb. I gotta put the bomb on, Mike. But what he said? Well, who the fuck is this trying to sit here in Periscope? Why the fuck I'm Periscoping this shit? 1404. I say hail to the. Hell to the no, no, no. Hell to the no. That's all y'all getting. Y'all getting a little baritone ash right there. But what he said was when, what's that boy's name? When Miles pretty much gave Milan a two-piece and a motherfucking biscuit. Oh, that exactly. When he gave his ass a two-piece and a motherfucking biscuit, New Orleans Little, what's the fuck up, bro? Oh, shit. What's up? The joy of the shit. When fucking Miles gave Milan a motherfucking two-piece and a motherfucking biscuit, Milan said, I would have walked his ass like a dog, but because I was in love, I called the Pope. What kind of bitch shit is that? What kind bitch shit, y'all? Any fucking way. Exactly. Bitch shit. I'm saying, I'm watching this. If y'all want to know about the interview, go to the, I believe if I'm not mistaken, it's theshaderoom.com. If not, just go to Google, type in the Shade Room, and look for Milan. Milan did a motherfucking interview. Yes, bitch ass is in the house. 100 motherfucking percent. But I'll beat your ass right, right now. But, you know, he did that shit, and I'm just like, here's some real shit now. I love hard. I really do. I do love hard. But, and here's the thing. If I'm with my girl and shit, and she put her hands on me, I'm not, and I need y'all to listen to what I'm going to say and follow me to the end. My first instinct, if she hit me, is to sit here and lay hands on her in the name of the Lord. But I'ma walk the fuck away, and if I can't go to another motherfucking room, I'ma get in my motherfucking vehicle, and I'ma let that bitch hit a motherfucking tire, screech on that motherfucking ass, and I'm not coming back for a hot minute. Now, if the place that we fucking in is my place, in my name, and I'm paying for the shit, you getting the fuck out. And if you not finna get the fuck out, I got many a motherfucking women in my life, I'ma call it, and I'ma let your ass know. If you don't fucking leave, I'ma call Claire. I'ma call Nika. I'ma call these people over here. They will escort your ass out the motherfucking house. It's best that your ass leave. Best that your ass leave. But same-sex relationship is shit. I would have laid hands. I would have sat here and I wouldn't even gave his ass a two-piece and a motherfucking biscuit. Would have gave his ass a motherfucking apple pie. You know, fucking croissant shit and shit. I would have laid that ass smooth. You ain't finna sit here and fucking touch me. That's what the fuck you ain't gonna do. Molly, that's old. So come on now. Come on now. That's what the fuck you ain't gonna do. What the fuck you ain't gonna do. That's how I already know when I'm on that bitch shit. I'm still trying to rock with Milan. I don't know if it's gonna happen, y'all. I don't. Score not, baby. All right. Now, what the fuck else he said? So now, he says in the same interview that he has a restraining order on Miles. Oh, somebody's scared. But it's because he started to see signs of crazy that lets me know you not motherfucking ready. And again, did y'all see the height differential between those motherfucking two? You better be motherfucking scared, shit. Like I said, I told y'all ask what he was doing that motherfucking video for. What was it? West Coast, East Coast, whatever the fuck that shit was. Dick Chick Boss, what up, boo boo? How you doing? When he did that motherfucking video for that shit, I told y'all ask Hey, he gave y'all ass motherfucking Ted Pendergrass on your ass. With him sitting here and singing motherfucking low and then yelled at your ass. Turn off the lights and light a candle. Turn them off! That's what the fuck he gave your ass. That lets your ass know that he motherfucking Milan motherfucking dumb as shit. He ain't watching motherfucking side. Here's the thing. We already know that motherfucking Milan is a motherfucking power bottom. Sit here and take and light a candle to that. Sit here and take it every which way. Legs to the moon. Fucking motherfucking Rashida on that motherfucking. Sit your ass a mother. Sit your ass a fuck down and shit. Any fucking way, because I still got more to talk about Milan, bitch ass. Nah, I still got more. The fuck else he say? Then he said he has secretly recorded audio that he didn't have with Milan while they were on three-way. Now, here's the thing. Before I finish this, for y'all who have newly joined, please go ahead and, I'm going to say it again, share this on Twitter, share this with your followers, bring them on in, because we love it over here. We a crazy ass bunch, but bring them on in. Go ahead and share this shit. But he didn't record it, the shit. Now, I'm not mad he recorded, okay? Because I'm going to do a, like I said, I got hella videos to do in December. Thank you, Thick Chicks Blog. Thank you so much. I have hella videos to do in December. Like I said, I'm going to do a video every day in December. But, outside of that, y'all know what my profession is. Y'all know. I, when I'm, like, when somebody, Maya Angelou said it best, when somebody shows you who they are, believe them. We got to talk about Empire. Okay, I'm going to make a note of that. I wasn't thinking about talking about Empire, but we could talk about Empire. I'm going to write it. I'm right. Hold on, wait. Now, my fucking handwriting is fucked up because I've been drinking, but I done wrote it down. Empire. I made a note. Yes, my birthday is on the 23rd. Motherfuckers, Capricorn in this motherfucking bitch. Motherfucking representing. Who Capricorn? I think it's myself. I think Ashley Shy Miller is a Capricorn. The Ghetto View is a Capricorn. Like, y'all got Capricorns in this bitch. I can't speak for them. My ass is gonna shut. You a Capricorn too? That's right. Ain't no shade on the Sagittarius. We ain't talking about y'all right now. No shade. Oh, I've been drinking. I've been dry. Shit. Cause I've been drinking. I've been drinking. Got this little guy a nice tea in my cup. I've been drinking, y'all. I've been drinking. Intuit. I, in my profession, when somebody shows me who the fuck they is, when I say I record conversations, and I'm in North Carolina, so you can record conversations, that shit's perfectly fucking legal. I record conversations, because when you sit here and show me, she laughing, when you show me who the fuck you is and that you ain't about shit, especially when your ass is quick to fucking lie, I'm record secretly. And it is what the fuck. And it's not because I'm a bitter bitch. Because I'm a bitter hoe. It's because I live by, you know, the whole trust no one, watch everyone, and protect your ass. And what I do for a living, you have to protect who you are. You have to. You have to. And because you don't, because somebody can sit here and sit here and make you believe I'm here for you and be the first motherfucker to stab you in your motherfucking back. So I'm cool with that. And I just told y'all some shit, right? You the same way, I got it. But the fact that he said this in the motherfucking interview, motherfucker, you never tell a is that a CYA, bitch? Cover your ass. Actually, not cover your, I should have said protect your ass. When you gotta cover your ass, that means you done did some shit and you cover it. I should have said protect your ass. You protect your ass from the jump. But what I'm getting at is this. You never sit here and show a motherfucker what your hand is. If this your motherfucking hand right here, you never fucking do this shit right here. He dumb as fuck. Dumb as shit. Man, I swear, I can't do it with Milan. I can't do it with Milan. I can't see it for Milan. But he did have one piece of saving grace, but I'm going to talk about that ass. Yeah, you got. You got to do it, Mike. So he said that. Now, he wants to get his tattoo covered, y'all. He want to get the tattoo covered. You don't do Milan? It's probably because you've been on social media more than, because you know I've been away for two whole fucking damn weeks. So I ain't know shit that was going on. But the fact that now you want to get the motherfucking tattoo covered. Get the fuck out of here. Get the fuck out of here. What else he said? Now, did his mother say that he had sugar daddies? Sugar daddies. Nah. But he don't want to say names. This is the one time. First and foremost, I ain't got a tattoo at all. And those are real shit. If I was to ever get a tattoo, one, it would be meaningful. The only time I would ever get a name tattooed on my body, it wouldn't even be my damn wife. It would be my damn children. Even if my children did me so motherfucking bogus, because they are from me and they got my motherfucking blood and half of my damn DNA, those would be the only names. Only fucking names. If I did. But he got sugar daddies, but he's not saying names. I can respect him for that. He was revealing too much in this interview, but I can respect the fact that he was like, yeah, mother's been tricking on me, but I ain't saying no names. So I can respect him for that. I can. Thank y'all for the hearts again. Thank you. What else we got? And the last thing that I'm going to talk about before I move on, because I'm tired of his ass. He says that he brought Miles to Love and Hip Hop. Miles did not bring him to Love and Hip Hop. And in him saying that, that makes me think it was the Shade Room. If I'm not mistaken, it is the Shade Room, okay? I'm not even going to talk about why people get tattoos. I ain't trying to sit here and, you know, offend more people than what I've done. But he was just like, I brought him to Love and Hip Hop. My whole thing is this. And I try my best not to use the N-word, but nigga, is we salty? Bitch, is we salty? Ho, is we salty? I'm trying to figure out, is you salty now? Exactly, stole the shine off that ass. I'm trying to figure out why the fuck you salty. Because he had to make that shit perfectly fucking clear. I brought you. Now, what I will say is, I don't want to dig deep. I really don't. But apparently, Miles and his strong face ass sister has been doing hella fucking in the beach water. Been sitting here doing hella fucking oh shit, planting. Don't do that. But has been doing interviews of the Wuha and saying all type of shit. Who is that? Is that Hated 036? Say how you doing? They've said a whole lot of shit, so it is what the fuck it is, but I'm gonna move the fuck on. Let's talk about the reunion. The reunion has not come out yet. Now, y'all know what the channel, my YouTube name is, Spilling All the Tea Proper. Y'all know what my moniker name is, Tea Spilling. I have been looking for the damn reunion. I will find this shit. I'm going to, because you cannot tell me the fucking reunion is not out, but it's all these fucking mini clips of the reunion. If you guys are not on the T-Spilling, aka Spilling All the Tea fan page, go ahead and go to facebook.com/spillingallthetea together. You'll find it. Proper. And I uploaded the clips that I saw. But let me say this, because we ain't seeing a whole lot of shit. But y'all already know what team I'm on. Y'all already know who I fucks with in this bitch. Y'all know who I fucks with. With lemon sugar and honey. Oh, definitely with the honey. I gotta make this shit sweet. Make this shit palatable. I got to make sure that I do that shit all day. I'm giving y'all as old school Spilling All Tea with the tea and the motherfucking vape. Y'all better be ready on that ass. But Y'all know I'm fucking Team Moniece. I'm working on the logo for the Team Moniece t-shirt. Y'all know I am. Now, I'm waiting to see the previews because if she's not going to be on next season, I will not. I'm not going to say I won't watch, but I'm going to wear the t-shirt. Now I might wear the t-shirt any fucking way. Y'all know I'm Team Moniece all motherfucking day long. I loves me some motherfucking Moniece fuckfest. But I love me some Moniece. Now, I think from the previews that we saw, most of what we saw is centered around Moniece. Because everybody has shit to say about Moniece now. Y'all know people have some shit to say about my boo, baby. But one thing I want to point out is, if you watch closely, if y'all haven't seen the clips again, go to my Facebook fan page for Spilling All the Tea. It is facebook.com/spillingallthetea together, proper, like Lady Nika said. And the clips are there. Just click them and watch them. But what I will say is this. It went from Moniece talking about everything, and she even said that she was trying to just get closure with Drew Fizz, aka. And the way the shit was cut, it wasn't like that. Again, Fizz was on that bitch shit because he could have kept that shit to himself. But at the same exact time, if you gonna have pillow talk with this motherfucking Mattel knockoff, motherfucking Tupperware knockoff, motherfucking I wanna be Rubbermaid motherfucking knockoff, motherfucking I got your ass from Dollar General motherfucking knockoff, motherfucking plastic ass knockoff, motherfucking bitch. Tell your, here's the thing, cause she ain't no motherfucking main motherfucking course. The bitch ain't motherfucking dessert and shit. Motherfucking got a motherfucking video with motherfucking Molly Mile and shit. The bitch ain't no, she ain't even a motherfucking appetizer. She the shit that you leave on the motherfucking table when you walk into the motherfucking restaurant and shit that you nibbling on until you motherfucking order for your food and shit, even your motherfucking appetizers and shit. That's what the fuck Nikki bitch ass is and shit. But I digress. But this bitch, you can see her trying her best to sit here and, you know, try to make it to where Moniece don't come for that ass. Shit, the bitch ain't on the menu. Ain't on the motherfucking menu at the fuck all. But what you can fucking see if y'all watch the shit, she's sitting here trying to make it seem like, look, Drew, motherfucking, this motherfucker right here, hold up. I'ma go the fuck in. Because, now here's the thing. I'm not gonna say Plastique came, and now Plastique, shout out to Lady Nika. I'm not gonna say she came with receipts, but she was saying that Fizz, Drew bitch ass, and her and motherfucking, you know, Rashette Dollars that sat here and exchanged emails. So this shit was in the motherfucking works and shit. You feel what I'm saying? Oh, I'ma go the fuck in. Cause y'all know I'm motherfucking Team Moniece. Motherfucking, let me hit my damn vape right quick, and I need to fucking fill this shit up. I've been smoking this shit too long. Hold on. Bring my blood pressure down, because y'all know I got high blood pressure in this shit. But what I'm saying is, she knew, based off her actions in the motherfucking finale, that motherfucking Moniece was about to get in it ass. Motherfucking Moniece gave y'all ass motherfucking track realness, jumped over that motherfucking barrier, was about to get in that ass, bitch. Okay, you Team Moniece, that's right, baby. Be Team Moniece, about to get in that motherfucking ass. And you try to talk shit and shit, right? You gonna throw a drink and shit, right? But when Moniece jump over that motherfucking barricade and shit, right? You ain't nowhere to motherfucking... She ain't nowhere to be found. Thank y'all for the heart. I'm just saying, I'm Team fucking Moniece. I'm Team fucking Moniece. If you watching this, baby, see this motherfucking pearl of whites and shit. I love you, baby. If you want to holler at a motherfucker, bring your ass on over. I'm a holler at your ass and shit. Flow your moves, yeah. But it's, they know. But if y'all have to go to my fan page, check out the YouTube clips and shit. But you will see that she was that Plastique. Who the fuck? Fizz. Fizzette. Bitch ass. Hold on. faster than this on your ass. Jump that shit. Give your ass track realness. Track fucking tease on that ass. Jump that shit quick. But Plastique, indirectly, and I gotta watch the review and shit. I have to watch the reunion. Because I think that Moniz getting ready to fucking pounce on that ass is it's gonna be a two-parter. It's gonna stop right there. I have that fucking feeling. Okay, I got that feeling. I'ma see it. What? Hold on. What you mean I'ma see it with Moniz? Okay, because I have been abstinent. I have not had sex with anybody in 14 years. Okay, if anything, I'ma done so motherfucking hard, it's gonna be like scary movies, and that bitch gonna be on the motherfucking ceiling. I'm trying to figure out how the fuck I'm sick. You need to tell. Let me pull another damn drink, because I need to pull another damn drink. Come on, lady nigga, let me know. Let me know. I need for you to let me know how the fuck my ass gonna sin. Cause I'm not against shading my own motherfucking ass. you here's the thing, y'all. Let me tell you, I have been abstinent for 14 years. And I will give you guys a story time for December. Y'all gonna know why, how, and all that good jazz. Okay, y'all will know. But I won't let a nigga. I had to pull another drink on y'all asses to let me know how the fuck I'm gonna sin with Moni. I'm waiting. I'm definitely waiting. In 10 fucking way. But what I'm saying is, I think that after kind of gathering everything, I'm saying that when I say we brothers and sisters, I'm trying to tell y'all now. You know what? Well, kudos for 3 years. Kudos for 3 fucking years. Just wait for that. Wait for that fucking tea time talk. Cause I'm gonna tell y'all the story as to why y'all gonna get y'all life now. Have your ass on the ceiling, scary movies on that ass, bitch. Have your ass. I'ma hit that shit so motherfucking hard first time around, bitch. Have your ass not only through the motherfucking headboard, but through the motherfucking wall on that ass, cause I ain't had no motherfucking pussy in the motherfucking baby. Don't have me spit out this good ass drain now. Don't have me spit out this good ass drain now. Okay, you know what? Right quick, forgive me, you guys. I have to step away for like another 30, like 45 seconds. I'll be right the fuck back. Don't go away. On some real shit, I'll be right back. Hold on. Okay, I'm back. Hopefully I wasn't going too long. Hopefully y'all asses are still here. EMT for recovery. Here's the thing. If y'all have not noticed, I ain't got no motherfucking sense. I'm going to talk about some real shit. We going to talk about some shit on this. Look, y'all. It's a reason that my tabloids and trending topics with T is on Periscope. Because we need to talk, okay? And I'm going to talk about some real shit. Also, I am on Blab. I'm thinking about putting this on Blab. I'm thinking about this. But, at a minimum, since Lady Nigga's on here, she and I need to do a Blab. Okay. Throwing that out there. Hot damn. I might have to go away again, because if y'all can see, like, the fucking levels in my damn vape is, look, I've been vaping like a motherfucker on this video. I have not vaped on y'all asses, and I'm giving y'all throwback, spilling all the TT, spilling T's on that ass. But into fucking way, back to Plastique and Moniz. Now, I think the only reason that Plastique defended Moniz is because she knew Moniz had targets that Moniz's ass was gonna go for. And it seemed like when Moniz was gonna get hype, that motherfucking Shonda, Yes, the vape. You know what? It's because of you that I had to bring the vape back for this. You talked about it, the vape is coming back on that ass. But I think because of the simple fact that she knew the shit was gonna come, if y'all see, Naysway, how you doing, baby boo? Come on now, come on in this damn thing now. We talking about some real shit, talking about love and hip and hop and shit. But what I think is this. I think she knew I might have an ass whooping coming. It shouldn't have left. I'ma tell y'all when I'm after this, I'ma tell y'all why the vape left, and then I'ma go back into love and hip hop. But I think the reason why she did that shit because she knew Moniece was coming for some bitches. And if y'all go to my fan page now and check the shit out, you will see. You will see Moniece at a minimum is legal to get confrontational with Shonda. You know, cause I'm in love with a stripper, she ride and she roll, she ride on that pole. Cause I'm in love with a stripper on that pole on your ass, and motherfucking crazy ass Brandon. You saw that shit was going down again. I told y'all, pay per view. I will pay for it, Brandon and Moniece. But moving the fuck on, I can't wait for the reunion. I can't. Now I'ma continue on with love and hip hop in a minute. But if you guys want to know why the vape went away, this is the reason why. I am, y'all know what I do for a living, so I'm not going to say it. But they have pretty much said that vaping is the same as cigarettes, so technically, I'm not supposed to do it indoors, because you're not supposed to smoke indoors. And I'm doing it for this video because, yes, Sopa Dead Ding was requesting it. And I'm going to just bring it back in general, but again, people that I work with, they've been trolling my shit so they know what the fuck I do. So if they wanted to, they could sit here and get me for, you know, you are violating regulations because you have decided that you wanted to sit here and vape indoors. The fuck out of here. Anyway, so let's go ahead and do a little bit of love and hip hop in New York. Now, Erica Mena, that hoe, who is no longer on Love & Hip Hop New York, which if you guys have not noticed, hold on, wait. You know what? It is what the fuck it is. I'm in enough motherfucking trouble. It's enough shit going on in my life. I ain't here to have a fucking pity party, but I'm here to give y'all ass some motherfucking entertainment and life on that motherfucking ass. But she was on Love & Hip Hop New York. She is no longer on Love & Hip Hop New York. But she decided to chime in on the Milan and Miles situation. And apparently her cousin has something to do with it. This and third, I really don't care. But moving the fuck on. So now, truly talking about Miss Remy Ma. Now, if you guys are watching this on YouTube, and I'm saying this for a reason, you guys will see the pictures of what I'm about to say. But Remy Ma has said that she is the GOAT, aka the greatest of all times in terms of female rap artists. That's what she even said. Now, from what I have on my nudes, she pretty much said none of the rap chicks ever, whether they're past, present, or future, could fuck with me. I say exactly what I feel, whether I feel it, and most of all, no one says anything about it. Now, y'all know Remy Ma was locked up. I'm sorry. Locked up, they won't let me out. She was locked up, y'all. She was locked all the way up. But, Lashy Tail, come on now. come on, Southside, baby. But, she said this shit, and I'm just like, part of me really thinks that, because we all know that the reunion for Love & Hip Hop Hollywood is only a two-parter. And right after the two-parter ends, Tamara. Let's not bring Tamara in this. But Wait a minute. Well, here's the thing. Again, y'all have to look at this from the bigger picture. I think a lot of this was said because, again, Love & Hip Hop New York is going to air in 3 weeks. So part one of Love & Hip Hop Hollywood is going to air this Monday. Part two the following. And if I'm not mistaken, Love Hip Hop Hollywood, New York, is either going to air the same exact day as part two or the following week. So that's why it's dumb, because again, we got to build this hype. But that's why the fuck she said now, she the best. Periscope bullshit. I'm going to say this. I'm not going to say that Remy Ma is the best, especially since the last shit we done truly heard, she had a mixtape out in 2014. She going too far. But 2014, bitch, we at the end of 2015 right now. Your album came out in motherfucking 2006 and shit. You need to sit here and come with some motherfucking receipts if you saying past, present, and soon to be future that you the best motherfucking one to do it. Okay. Oh, she reaching, but she's trying to build the hype. And I understand. Again, y'all got to think about it. They, most people are using every form and fashion of social media to hype shit. Now, let me say this. You not watching Love & Hip Hop, do you? I'ma watch it. Y'all know I'ma watch this shit, okay? But let me say this. We cannot sit here and deny that even though Remy Ma's body may not necessarily be snatched all the way, her body look good than a motherfucker. Not watching a review, I'm just saying, but her body look good though. That body looking good. Shit, she been drinking her motherfucking milk on that ass. Oh, don't do me like that, nigga. Don't do me like that now. You know what? Mona is a coon, but here's the thing, though. Even though I don't really fucks with Mona, get your money the way that you fucking get it. You feel what I'm saying? You know, it's one of those things where it's just like, if I could be honest, Love & Hip Hop New York, which is the original. If you guys really watch the original, at least first two seasons, borderline three season, were the most legit. If y'all really research how this shit came about, they were mostly following Jim Jones. And it was the realest shit. The realest shit. You feel what I'm saying? So that's what it was. But it went from the, it's entertainment, yes, but it went from realness to what the fuck it is. That's why I say she needs to go to Chicago and get that realness. I just don't think she ready. Better yet, do a motherfucking Love & Hip Hop Detroit and Chicago, nigga Scott Young, as Alexander Rogers like to say. You get your ass some motherfucking ratings and shit. I'm just saying. You know what? Here's the thing. People can clown Tyra Banks. But if I'm not mistaken, 21 or 22 seasons of America's Next Top Model, and now this is the last damn season, clown her all the fuck you want. But who the fuck getting they damn coins, though? Shit, Love Hip Hop. I'm telling you now, Love Hip Hop Chicago, baby. Go get her some motherfucking views in this bitch. I'm trying to tell y'all. Alaska? I don't know who's in Alaska right now. But, I mean, they have Alaska shows. I cannot think of it. MTV Slatnecks. Slatnecks. They did Slatnecks. And somebody I used to work with, he used to date somebody that was actually on the show. And I enjoy Slatnecks. Now, Love & Hip Hop Alaska? I don't know. But moving the fuck on. So we're done with Miss Remy Ma. Throw that away. Let's talk about as Jasmine kinda Stevie. You know I love you, Stevie. 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 Nika, stop that. You done brought me all. I was trying to get into. Stop that. Anyway. Stevie J. We all remember, she said, oh, okay. We all remember from last season that he went to rehab, all that good jazz, what's going on with him. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Blah, blah, blah. Well, guess what? He is heading back to rehab. I'm waiting for their actual show to come out. I cannot wait. Who is that? Is that Jose's daughter? How you doing, babe? Maybe. See, here's the thing. You know what? I'm glad you said that. Because Lady Nika has sat here and accused me of low-key shading. Of sitting here and shading with a straight face and making her spit out her drink many a fucking times. I'm glad you said that. Because that was her fucking turn. And before I finish the little giveaway that I have going on for, you know, my channel, that will, like I said, I will give you guys the names of that very, very soon. Ow, your keyboard now. Don't do me like that. Don't. I did not tell you to sit here and eat or drink while you watch my videos. I never told you to do that. You did that on your own. When I watch YouTube, I don't eat or drink shit. I don't do that shit. You want your shit too? Anti fucking way. Moving on, cause she tripping right now. She tripping. Let me get my notes. Got my notes. So we all know. Hold on, wait. I'm giving you a keyboard. So we all know what happened to him. That he went to rehab last season. All that good jazz. Well. He went to rehab last year or last season because he had failed 10 drug tests in a row. Well, he has failed yet another drug test. So instead of doing jail time, they have ordered him. Hello, Black Bart Breezin. El Nays Ways back. They've ordered him to attend outpatient rehab. And if I'm not mistaken, I think twice a month instead of going to rehab. And he's going to have random drug testing. It might be because the Puerto Rican princess give him some of that Puerto Rican spice that he ain't quite motherfucking ready for. Either that or the show is really getting to him. How is what going? Let me know. How is what going? You gotta be specific now. How is what going? Because I have one more bit. I got one more love of hip hop thing to talk about before I get to, like, I have to say the very end. Hey, Black Iku shout out is my shit, baby. Okay. I'm going to say this. If you guys have not seen my Black Iku Chicago review for the last one that I did, please watch it. I will say I included two song clips, right? And my video, and I don't feel like fighting it because I'm truly fucking tired with YouTube and people trying to come for a little fish like me. But I added two clips in that video. It was Megan Trainor's 3 a.m. and Teddy Pendergrass, you know, come on over to my place, right? And they only noticed that Megan Trainor's 3 a.m. song was displayed in my video, not Teddy Pendergrass video, which is more syndicated than any fucking thing. I didn't feel like fighting it, but what they pretty much did is any money that I get off of that video, because it is monetized somewhat, that record company is going to get that money. So it is what the fuck it is. But if you guys want to watch it, watch that video. I know that YouTube shit. I got a video about that shit and Viacom too. Coming in December. But watch that video, because if you guys watched the last episode of Black Iku Chicago and then you watch this, watch my Iku Chicago first, then watch my video. I'm telling you, when you watch my video, you're gonna laugh. Just don't eat or drink shit, because then you're gonna be like, you know, Lady Nika, and spin on your computer and phone and keyboard and shit. And then y'all gonna try to accuse me of owing y'all some motherfucking money. Into fucking way. Let's go ahead and get to the. I know. Well, here's the thing. The video is still good in the U.S. It's just not a worldwide video. It is what the fuck it is. I don't care. I don't even feel like fucking fighting it right now. I'm just fucking done. So let's go ahead and finish out Love and Hip Hop so I can move on to the last couple things that I have. And then you guys are good for the rest of y'all days now. You keep saying all you keyboards. Stop that. Stop it. Anyway, let's talk about Young Jock. They did not go into a lot of detail on who he bought the shit for. But in 2009, he went to a company called Aiden & Company and pretty much bought, what was it? A 24-karat diamond bracelet and a men's ring. And pretty much agreed that agreed to pay $17,500. That was his plan. Well, apparently he did not necessarily pay, and at this point he owes just shy of $80,000. So a Georgia judge has ordered that he owes them $18,000. That right there is Love and Hip Hop Atlanta for your ass. So I think we have successfully hit every, like, who is that? What's your name? Chris Hara? I think that's how you say your name. Hopefully I didn't say your name wrong. Welcome. But that is all that I have to say for Love and Hip Hop, y'all. So I have a couple of, dare I say, church announcements, though I think I've done that. You know what? We gonna deal with Mendes' ass when we fucking get there. I don't know if they repoed Jock. I don't know. I really, really don't know. But it is what it is. But I have a couple more things to talk about before I get to that. If you guys are not tracking, I have started a brand new venture. It is called BU365, or the title itself is Tea Spillings. 3UB65, aka hashtag TS for tea spilling, BU365. And it's for all those who are trying to, you know, kind of get back to their old selves, trying to lose some weight and all that good shit. Again, your boy done lost over 20 motherfucking pounds in the last 2 motherfucking months, trying to get ready for my birthday. Well, my birthday is next month, but trying to get ready for my birthday in 2016. It's my 33rd. And the blackout is in motherfucking next month. Well, not next month, next year in July. And I know that Sayshawn Bradley and Lady Nika are going to be there, as long as your boy ain't got a motherfucking deploy. You 13? Okay, here's the thing now, boo-boo. I love you, but we talk about Capricorns right now. I ain't trying to shit on you now, but Capricorns right now. But Sayshawn Bradley and Lady Nika, they are going to be in Las Vegas during the blackout. And as long as a boy don't deploy, kind of hints if y'all don't know what I do for a living, there it is. I will be there. It wasn't May, but apparently push it back to July. Okay. You claim it, baby. All right, let's claim the shit. You lost 35. That's right. Clap that shit up. Motherfucking. Come on, days where you lost 35 pounds in this motherfucker. But the whole BU365, it's all about everyone coming together and creating their own plan that fits their life to lose weight rather than following on social trends and everything. And when I say 20 pounds, it's actually more, but 20 pounds and descending. I'm doing so much for the cause. Hopefully you guys join me. The current challenge is keep a diary from December 1st to December 31st. I have a challenge for January, but we're not going to talk about it. Hopefully you guys join me. And the fact that the fucking blackout is in fucking damn July, your boy got to be snatched and all that shit. Like, this shit got to be nice, right, and tight for that shit on y'all asses, baby. The blackout is supposed to be in Las Vegas, if I'm not mistaken. Yes, call me. I need to be on that now. I gotta be on that. But what I'm saying is that is further motivation. Like I said, I'm trying to do my dirty 30. Like I said, I turn 29 next month, but I turn 30 next year in December. So I'm trying to be all the way to fuck together for my 30th birthday party. But because the blackout is in July, I need to be all the way together. Because if I'm not, somebody gonna read my ass for utter fucking filth and dust, and we don't want that. Okay. Oh, here's the thing. When this video done, I'm calling your ass. You think I fucking play? When I'm done with this video, be by your damn phone. Because within the minute, I'm calling your ass. So let's go ahead and move to the next part of this video. Because again, we're almost done, you guys. We're almost done. Thank y'all for fucking sticking it out with me. Because I know we've been on here for a hot minute. Okay. So let's go ahead and talk about congrats. Because I have some congrats for y'all. See what I work with? You know what? Fuck it. I might add this out the video, but fuck it. All right, y'all. All right, that's it. That's it. Like I said, I still got some love handles and shit, but when I say I'm slitting down, if I showed y'all what I look like before and what I look like right now, trust me, you will see a vast fucking difference. If you guys did not see my video of me introducing BU365, you will see pictures of me back in 2008, y'all will see just how skin tipped my ass was. Nika, don't come on, that's don't be fighting no Periscope. Don't look, y'all. My sister, she is protective now. She will come for y'all. Don't do it, cause she will come now. I know my face is, you know, all nice and slenderized and shit. You know, gotta sit here and be sexy for y'all asses. I'm trying to show y'all how to fuck 30 gonna look on y'all asses. I'ma look so motherfucking good when I do the fucking face by face. Y'all gonna be like, bitch, your ass look like your ass is 20 years old again. Better yet, younger. I'ma do it on y'all asses. So let's go ahead and get these congrats out the way. Because I want to end this video on a good note. Okay? Plenty of good notes. So, oh, I'm going to bring 30 in, right, y'all? When the time comes for me to turn 30, when I say y'all going to be flooded with fucking videos, y'all going to be fucking flooded. And, actually, I'm not going to say it, but I'm going to talk to my sister after this. We got some planning to do for that dirty 30. Bitch! When I say dirty 30, the whole thing is when y'all see the shit. You know what? Right quick, when the whole thing of BU365, the whole thing is, it is 365 days of the year, and it's not just 1 year. The whole purpose of it, and I'm going to just do a quick little service announcement for y'all. The whole thing is, we all are from different walks of life, and I mean this wholeheartedly. This is me being serious. I said, I'm black. My mother is Baptist, my father is Catholic, and I converted to Judaism. Again, that's going to be the title of my book if I ever write it. But given all of that and the fact that my faith is Judaism, like between a few American holidays that I actually celebrate and Jewish holidays, it's one of those where it makes it hard. And December is probably going to be the hardest month for me. But trying to, you know, kind of help everybody into... Well, here's the thing. Eventually, when I get my coins up and shit, the whole BU365, or more or less just the whole BU movement, will be an actual thing. But you guys get to get in on it when it's in its fucking early stages on some real shit. But the whole purpose of it is we all take our backgrounds and blend it. Like for me, like saying me have, you know, being of the Jewish background, and even the black background with soul food, I like to make Jewish dishes. Or even soul food dishes with a Jewish, you know, fucking Jewish dishes with a soul food tang, or, you know, y'all get what the fuck I'm trying to say. I've been sitting here. But the whole, and I said, I even want to go, you know, do apps and shit and really try to make it to where people can do a questionnaire down the road. And from there, from the database that I want to do, you know, kind of have workout plans specific to individual peoples and whatnot. I'm not fucking with Amazon right now. But it's one of those where it's just like trying to help people get to that place to where it's not all about fitness and dieting, but being a better you. Again, I've lost over 20 pounds in the last 2.5 months. You feel what I'm saying? And I know what I'm doing. Like I said, when I show, like, if y'all watch my introductory video to BU365, you will see where the fuck I was. And I went from fucking 220 to a motherfucking 183 on y'all asses, okay? I know what I'm doing. But it's one of those where it's just like, I want to try to get it to where we all can come in together. And with the BU365 fan page on YouTube, where we all can come together and we inspire each other. Because it's not about me making money right now. But it's all about us, you know, coming together and inspiring each other. And just really trying to help us get to that better place for us. Because when I say, I may not necessarily be where I want to be for the blackout, but when I say for my dirty motherfucking 30, your boy gonna be all the way put together. But let's go ahead and get into the last bit of this video, okay? So for congrats, Ice-T and Coco, they are expecting a baby girl. Her name is Baby Chanel. So that is a good thing right there. And let's go ahead and get all the babies and shit out the way. NBA star, I believe his name is Kyrie Irving. Hopefully I'm not saying his name wrong, but he's expecting a newborn. Melanie Fanona and her Chanel is born. Right, they are, it is born. I'm sorry, newborn. But Melanie Fanona, her boyfriend Jerry, I think it's Cotter, they're expecting a baby. Had her yesterday. Look, I've been drinking, y'all. Y'all have to excuse me. I have been drinking. Y'all saw me drinking on this video, so I'm a little bit, yeah. But there's that. And a couple things. Tyler Perry and Benny Siegel, they have lost quite a bit of weight. I know people shame the fuck out of Tyler Perry because apparently he has liposuction and a little bit of a constructive surgery on his abdomen and whatnot. It's good to hear about it, but you need to get the fuck back in the studio and give us some motherfucking throcals, okay? Sing on that ass. But, you know, I said she's expecting a baby, but Beanie Siegel and Tyler Perry, they have lost quite a bit of weight, and I'm happy for them. Congrats. And, you know, I done talked about the head doctor from Love and Hippity Hop. Well, Superhead, or as I want to say, PhD head, Corinne Stephens, she is getting her PhD. It is in human sexuality, and she is currently giving up speeches across campuses in the U.S. Just want to throw that out there. But again, even though we have many shows, let's clap it up for her, okay? And the very last thing that I want to talk about before I get off here with you guys and before I call my sister, Lady Nika, I know what her name is, I'm just not going to say it on y'all. A female by the name of Shirley Chris Holm, hopefully I'm saying her name right. She received the Pulse Humus, hopefully I'm saying that right too, Presidential Medal of Freedom. So she ran for president back in 1972. Hopefully my sis Squeeze Jones will talk about this in her, you know, Focus February. But, you know, she did that. She's the first colored woman to run for president. And the first woman Democrat. She was the first black woman to, what was it? Oh, my gosh. Be elected to Congress in 1960. On this past Tuesday, President Barack Obama says, you know, her example will transcend her life. And she passed away in 2015. So, shout outs to her for doing great things, setting a beautiful example. And even though this was a long ass video, thank you guys for joining me. This is it for Tabloids and Trending Topics with T. In the event you guys are trying to figure out where the T spelling and all this come from, where I serve, my last name is Thomas. I want to try leaving a good update. My initials for my job is Tango Sierra TS, and for Thomas THOMAS TSTS T spelling. So the whole spin all the T and everything, it's all in my name. So thank you guys for joining me for this long ass video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you guys so much for sharing. This will be on YouTube very soon. And please come back for the Real Households of Atlanta. You know what? You can also catch it on the review and everything. So I love you guys. Thank you so much for watching. I love you guys. Bye. And I will see you guys.